Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with a very important topic related to health. Now this topic is National Medical Commission Bill, and there has been a lot of hullabaloo about this bill. So in this class we will be understanding what are the areas of concern with respect to this bill. Now before we understand that, we need to understand health sector in particular. Now when it comes to health sector, we require regulation of doctors so that they practice their profession as per the right ethics, as per the ethical standards. That is the one requirement in the health sector. Then we also need to regulate the admission to the MBBS and to the master's programs with respect to this medicine field. And thirdly, we also need to manage and regulate hospitals, and fourthly we also need to manage and regulate medical colleges. So there are four things in this medical domain. Now when it comes to these domains, now all these domains are regulated and all these domains are administered by one parent body, that is Medical Council of India. Now because Medical Council of India has to regulate so many areas, by itself, by the kind of the work it is doing, it actually becomes a very powerful body, and it is actually a body that has also centralized a lot of power. So a lot of authority is centralized in this Medical Council of India. Now because a lot of power and authority is centralized in Medical Council of India, because more the power, more the corruption. Power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely. So this Medical Council of India has become a den of corruption. Now when it comes to increasing the seats in a college, this Medical Council of India provides permission to increase the medical seats in a particular college. For that, there is a lot of quid pro quo. Now when it comes to administration and management of the licenses of the doctors, again there is a lot of corruption, because it's a centralized body. Despite it being a democratic body, but being a centralized body, there's a lot of corruption in it, and there has been of late a lot of criticism against the Medical Council of India, the way they were handling this medical profession, medical education, medical colleges and hospitals. Now in order to change all this, in order to reform the situation, Government of India has come out with a bill, National Medical Commission. Now this National Medical Commission, it will actually be a changed body. It will be a transformed body in comparison to Medical Council of India. Now Medical Council of India, I've told you, it's a democratic institution. Only the doctors are part of it. But now with respect to this National Medical Commission, the government has proposed that there will be a participation of the officials too, means the IAS officers. They will also be getting participation in this. Plus there will be also participation, some of the members will be ex-officio members. So they have decided to make it a 20 member body, National Medical Commission. And plus what they have decided is to create four separate boards for different type of medical spheres. Different type of medical spheres means related to Ayush and related to homeopathy, and then related to allopathy, and then related to Ayurveda. So they will be creating four kind of boards who will be handling the education of all these separated domains. Plus there is very important thing contained in this bill, that is about crossing over to other domain, that is a bridge course. Now this is very important, bridge course. Now what is this bridge course? Now suppose someone is a doctor and he is practicing homeopathy, and he suddenly wants to practice allopathy. He believes that the allopathy will serve a better purpose for its patients, and apart from the knowledge of homeopathy, he should also be practicing allopathy. In that case, this bill has a provision for the bridge course. This is something that has created the hullabaloo. This is the second thing. Because what the critics are saying that apart from allopathy, the homeopathy and Ayurveda, the government will be actually coming out with a new domain of medicine, that is, they are criticizing it as by calling it as a crosspathy. that it will not result into anything, because it is neither a pure form of Ayurveda nor a pure form of homeopathy or a form of allopathy. So this is the reason why this bill has created a lot of hullabaloo. There has been a lot of criticism. Now, how we can actually handle the health sector and education? For that, we need to create separate bodies for everything. For hospital, there should be separate body so that there be no issues like the one has taken place recently in Max Hospital, where a baby was declared dead despite it being alive. So we need a separate body, because this is in itself a lot of professional domain. The second domain relates to the education of the doctors, the degrees, MBBAs and the master's degree. So there should be a separate thing for this. There should be a separate thing for managing the hospitals. There should be a separate thing for managing the colleges. So we need to actually bifurcate it. And we also need to not bureaucratize these institutions. But we also need to assure a lot of transparency and accountability. And that can be assured only if we will assure good governance in this domain of health sector. So that is the basic requirement. So the bill that we are coming out with, it is not an alternative. It is not a solution. It is not a panacea to the corruption that is crippling this very sector. So this was all for the day. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you have any sort of query with respect to this particular topic. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.